Hey everybody, it's TR from T-Man Performance again. I wanted to kind of go through our head torquing procedure. You know, we get a lot of calls with guys having troubles with head gaskets blowing on the M8s. Fortunately, we have not had that issue, but I do want to go through the way that we torque our heads and how we prep our head bolts and stuff, because to me, I think it's very important for the reason that we haven't had those issues. So first of all, I just wanted to show you the only head bolts that we use for the Milwaukee 8s is either the ARP, which is a fueling, or the Screaming Eagle, which is also an ARP bolt. We find that those seem to be the best head bolts. They don't have the stretch factor or anything like that. Personally, I like to use a stock Harley-Davidson stud in the cases. I like to have that shelf on the bottom of the stud that I can torque into the case, so to make it more stable. So one of the first things I want to show you, the reason that I use the ARPs is because when they're ground or when they're machined, they machine the shank here and the head at the same time. So this is all parallel to one another. So when you're torquing it, you get a nice smooth. I've seen on some other head bolts, some of the cast ones, some of the stock Harley ones, if you put them in the lathe and you chuck it here, this will have a tremendous amount of run out, which will not give for a nice steady pull. So, but one of the things that I do is if you look at some, I don't know if you can see it on these ARPs and the Harley ones, but if you see here where they put them, see how you see the burrs here that have like little, and you can feel them with your fingernails. And I think that that has a tendency sometimes to grab into the aluminum and not make a steady torque. So what I do is I just took an old Harley-Davidson stud that we've taken out, and I cut it off and I put it in my half inch drill. You can see right there. And that's just a crankcase stud. I just cut it off short. I screw the head bolt up on there. And then what I do is I just take my little 90 degree drill and I start it. And what I do is I just chamfer that edge is all I do. As you see right here, I just chamfer that edge. It makes it a real nice smooth, gets rid of any type of little burr or anything like that, which will make for a nice smooth pull. So that's my first step. Now, one of the other things I do is I always use the ARP grease on my studs and on the bottom end service. So when you get a bottom end service from us, you'll notice that when we put the studs in and we torque the studs in the case, I go ahead and lube them so that they don't get forgotten. So, okay? So that's kind of where we're at. This is our first step. I'm going to show you the next step that I do, which is where I lap the head bolt into the head. I know this seems a little too much, but I've always been that way. So I just want to show you the way that we do it, and then we'll go through our torque procedure, which I've changed up two or three times. We found one that we really feel works well, and then we'll show you how we do it. We'll go from there. But thank you very much.